Before we begin, how many of you play Team Fortress? Or at least have played? Excellent. This video is probably pretty old for you guys, but it's just something to present you what virtual reality is and can be.
I fear no man, but that thing. It scares me.
No, I ain't talking about that freak, all right? He's not here, is he? How do I get this f***ing thing off?
One shudders to imagine what inhuman thoughts lie behind that mask. What dreams of chronic and sustained cruelty.
Okay, now that we are on a fun start, let's continue. No. Can you help? I'm really good with touchpads. Okay, so who am I? My name is Olli Sinarmo. I'm a co-founder and project lead at a company called Mindfield Games, and our main focus is on virtual reality. How many of you guys have heard of Oculus Rift? Excellent. And for the people who have not raised their hands, it's a virtual reality device that is coming out in 2014, in this year's Christmas, and we are one of the first developers on the device. Just today we received a fun package from Oculus regarding their new development kit. Our other stuff that I have done in previous years, I have been a designer, I work in companies like Redlinx, Applifier, Mr. Good Living, and my previous project was the EveryPlay for Applifier, which was purchased by Unity Technologies in last March. And also I work for Pelit Magazine as a games reviewer. So I'm here to talk to you about future. If some of you haven't noticed, you are living the most excellent and interesting time of human history. I'm not only talking the past 100 years that the population has quadrupled, multi-doubled into billions of people around the planet. I'm talking about the last years where we have built permanent residence in space. We are landing small rovers on different planets. And we have this internet, whole humankind connecting device system that even Star Trek could only dream about. We also have some technologies that are not there yet, but we are really close to them. Self-driving cars, Google Glass, where you can photograph all your life events and share to your friends, even though your friends are not interested in seeing them. But luckily, you have a dystopian corporation of or whatever that is, NSA watching them. Yeah, funny joke. How does this relate to the future of gaming? So, playing the Matrix. I had a quote here from Morpheus on what the Matrix is, but you all have seen the movie, you know it. It's something that is the second reality above our own. Previous years, the second reality has not been that, like, really good looking. Say in 95, Nintendo did their Virtual Boy. It does look a bit like Matrix, but in a bad sense. And it didn't look even better 5 years later. But why now? Why is it now something that we should be talking about and not again like a failing promise? It's because of a small thing. The devices still look pretty much the same as they did 10 years ago, but there is a huge technological change that brought virtual reality to us. Pretty much everybody of you has it, along with themselves. Cell phones. What virtual reality needs, it needs really fast, high-resolution devices that are small, agile, and can be put in front of your eyes to create the immersion. And cell phones pretty much did that for us. This is a picture of the probably the best virtual reality kit currently available. It's done by a company called Valve, and it's the Steam VR. It's just a research project. But what you have there is like two cell phones glued together, some lenses put in between, and a room with wallpaper, tapestry looking with QR codes and such to create your positional tracking. When you combine these two, what you get is Star Trek Holodeck. It's pretty much there. We already have the technology to do the Star Trek Holodeck. It's just 2 years away from now. It's pretty amazing to think about this. So what was like the first thing to bring this to us? It was the Oculus Rift. It began a couple of years ago with a 90-year-old guy called Palmer Luckey. He had this idea that, hey, what if I put this cell phone in front of my eyes? Would it work? And with his technical skill and such, in 2012, he asked for $250,000. He got $2.4 million from Kickstarter. A year later, he got $75 million of funding from Netscape founder. And in past month, his company was sold for $2 billion to Facebook. A controversial choice by somebody. And, well, virtual reality developers like us were thinking like, okay, so instead of Kickstarter project, we now have Facebook and Sony doing virtual reality equipment. So there is definitely things are moving forward. Along with Oculus Rift, we have other Kickstarter projects, like say Cast AR. It's a bit different technology, it's augmented reality, where in virtual reality, we take 100% of your perception. With augmented reality, we add along other things to it. Cast AR is pretty interesting. Will it become a product? Remains to be seen. Vertuix Omni, that's an interesting technology in future, since now we are getting eyes for virtual reality. Next thing we will be getting will be hands. Vertuix Omni is already moving to your legs, to your body, adding a line, the whole body perception insight into a game. But not all of these become projects. Even good ideas, say video game gun. This was created by a guy in Texas. If you look that from the YouTube, you can pretty much see why it didn't come a product. He's a bit weird. But yeah, the idea was good. You just glue a LED screen into a toy gun and move around in 3D environments and shoot zombies. Pretty fun, never became anything. And we also have things that were not designed for virtual reality, but definitely work in it. This is PlayStation Move. I was lucky to try it out in GDC this year, where they had the new Morpheus kit along with the PlayStation Move, so you could see your own hands inside the gameplay. That was pretty amazing. You can see, for example, see yourself hacking up zombies or whatever. Another device, if working as advertised, would be the Microsoft Kinect. Instead of just hands, seeing your whole body. Getting a third-person outer body experience would be pretty interesting in VR. Okay, I can't remember what is my next slide. My next slide is about what kind of games work in virtual reality. So now that I have discussed about the technology, all the equipment you can put there, it's the software that matters. And the first thing, it's like a virtual reality developer cliche. We should do a game. Let's do something really fun that players would really enjoy to play. Oh, I got an idea. Let's do horror. People really love it. And you get the most horrible games ever. It's a playing horror games is too intense. Instead, if you cannot just look away from the TV, because when you look on the other side, there's the dead person again or everything. It's a horrible feeling, but it really does work. Other stuff that works really well, especially now that we don't have the body perception, are things where you sit. Games where you sit and see your own body when you look downwards. For example, this game is Private Eye. If you guys know Hitchcock's movie, The Rear Window, this is pretty much a remake out of it in a game world. You're a guy in a wheelchair looking out of your window and trying to figure out who is the murderer in the apartment next door. So it's a Peeping Tom game. And of course, simulators, space shooters, driving games, all of those work. You sit down, look out the environment around you. It feels awesome. Yep, and mech games. Of course, this is Hawken. They have had virtual reality working for them a while. And a couple of pictures from our game. I think this is like the first time I'm showing anything that we are doing. It does also work in if you provide an environment that is familiar and add something weird into it. So, besides of games, what does virtual reality make possible for us? Because it's just not gaming. That's like fundamentally wrong to think that virtual reality is only gaming and it's only gaming equipment. There are so many other possibilities that we can build into it. Let's see how much I have still time to rant. 5 minutes. Traveling. You can travel to places you cannot see on your free time. Say you want to see that, what the Niagara Falls look like when you're next to them. What do the pyramids look like? What did the pyramids look like when they're being built? All that is possible. What does the Mars rover see? All of this is possible in virtual reality. One thing is also what kind of movies. One of my predictions is that virtual reality might kill movie theaters, because instead of sitting in a crowded theater, I can get the largest screen ever in the world right in front of me back at my home. Or if I really enjoy movie theaters, I can make one for myself. And porn. Somebody was already thinking about porn. Adult stuff works. There are already, I'm not keeping that longer there. There are already 3 porn sites on the internet selling virtual reality porn, even though the device is not yet available. Think about that. So educational things, astronauts, they are being trained with virtual reality already. Architects, seeing how the world will look like when their buildings are built from the above as a god view or from the ground as pedestrians. Training against phobias, psychological things. For example, this person is being taught that when a tarantula walks on over your hand, there is nothing to fear about it. A really good thing to teach. Military training. This, and of course, police training, all hazardous jobs. And if this looks funny, like the guys are just running there inside a, looking like a lab room, this is what they're seeing. They're inside a jungle. There's enemy hiding somewhere around them and they're being trained for it. So even though I'm saying it's not for gaming, virtual reality is really a game. It's interactive entertainment that you can take part into. So that's pretty much before we get all the other stuff like fusion energy, AI singularity, virtual reality will be the next future tech we are getting. And from a science fiction movie, this could be like a virtual reality game company slogan, what the Weyland-Yutani Corp says, building better worlds. At Mindfield Games, we have the Eyes of the Future of Play. Thank you.